Yeah, I definitely have experienced racism, and I find that even among other models, mm-hmm. you know, when I go into a casting, they kind of look at me like, okay, what is she? As far to my knowledge, I'm the only, you know, First Nation model that has lived on the reserve, came off the reserve, and come this far in this industry. I actually went around to open calls, and you know, immediately they were like, wow, you know, we love your look, you know, and you know, we love, you know, your height, you know, yeah, maybe you gotta work on your measurements, but you got a great look, and you know, and then they would ask, you know, what's your background? So I would say, oh, I'm Jamaican. They're like, really? And then I'm like, yeah. And like, what else? And I'm like, Ojibwe. And they're like, what's that? And I was like, First Nation, from here. And they're like, oh, okay. And so they would take pictures and like, you know, we'll call you. And then I just got straight up told by an agency that, I'm sorry, but your look will not work. Our clients will not take your look. We can't find work for you. I realized that I have to work 10 times harder than anyone else, because there is still that when they, certain people will find out, you know, doesn't matter which part they're from in the industry, there's that kind of, all right. Yeah. There, you could still feel that little bit of tension in certain aspects with certain people that I have come across, or people just plain don't even know what that is. And then they tell me all their, you know, misconceptions, or some people say straight up, you know, all I know about, you know, First Nations people is from what I read in, you know, White Fang. I was like, oh, all right. We've got a lesson to teach here.
Yeah.
You know, at first it is hard. There are some times when it gets hard. Like, for example, you know, when I know for a fact that I have a look for something and they don't choose me, and, you know, they don't say why, or they go with, you know, the, you know, supposed norm, which is blonde hair, blue eyes. For some people that I have worked with, you know, they knew nothing, or they thought we were, honest to God, extinct. Like, I have met people who said, you know, I thought you guys were gone. So, and then, you know, they're like, oh, okay, they're not gone. So, you know, what else is there? So it leads them to explore. So it's kind of a two-way road. Being, you know, the only one in such an underrepresented group, it does get hard. But then at other times, you know, when people are genuinely interested and they want to know more, or they say, you know, why isn't there more of you in this industry? You know, then it's amazing. You know, and then I get to share, you know, a bit of my culture, and then, you know, kind of broaden their view